Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss chemical properties of base for class 10th chemistry. In previous lecture we have discussed chemical properties of acid. So here we are. First property, base reacts with acid. I think this property is same. In previous lecture we have understood acid reacts with base, now base reacts with acid. Again this is neutralization reaction. So what will happen? Base plus acid to give salt and water. It is a similar property of acid and base. They combine each other with each other to form salt and water is released. Example, base sodium hydroxide, acid HCl. Again double displacement reaction, NaCl plus water. Second, we can change the base, potassium hydroxide, change the acid, sulfuric acid. Again double displacement neutralization reaction, easy. So base reacts with acid to form salt and water is released. This is the first property, a similar property of acid and base. They combine with each other to form salt and water. Second property is base reacts with metals. Base reacts with metals. As we have discussed, most of the acids and most of the metals react with each other and hydrogen gas is released. But base reacts with only few metals. Those metals are aluminium, zinc, tin and lead. These metals react with base to give hydrogen gas. Other metals don't react with base. Clear? So what will happen? For example, zinc plus NaOH. This is base. So definitely this metal will behave as a acid. Na2ZnO2 plus hydrogen. We can balance. So this hydrogen gas is released and this is a sodium zincate. This is a sodium zincate. A complex compound is formed by the reaction of a metal with a base. Easy. Second example is aluminium. Aluminium, potassium hydroxide, again this is base, so metal will behave as a acid. What will happen? KaLO2. This is a potassium meta aluminate plus hydrogen gas is released. So are those type of metals react with acid as well as base. These metals are called amphoteric metals. The metals which react with acid as well as base, those metals are called amphoteric metals. Similarly, we can solve reactions for tin and lead. But all metals don't react with the base. Only a few metals which react with base, those are called amphoteric metals. Clear? Third property is base reacts with non-metallic oxides. Base non-metallic oxides. And if we compare with acid, acid reacts with the metallic oxide. That is the difference in chemical properties of acid and base. Again, base NaOH, non-metallic oxide, carbon dioxide. Actually, base is CO2 gas from atmosphere, carbonate, Na2CO3 plus water is released. Easy. Base reacts with non-metallic oxides to form carbonates if it reacts with CO2, and if it reacts with SO2, sulfur dioxide, again this is a non-metallic oxide. Now instead of carbonate, Na2SO3 is formed. Now this is a sodium sulfite. SO3 anion is called sulfite anion, and sodium combines with sulfite ion to form sodium sulfite plus water. This is the property number third. Base reacts with non-metallic oxides to form its carbonates or sulfides depending on the non-metallic oxides. Easy. Base reacts with ammonium salts to form ammonia. Base reacts with ammonium salts to form ammonia. For example, I have taken base KOH, ammonium salt, ammonium chloride. This is ammonium chloride. So what will happen again? Displacement, double displacement reaction. KCl formed plus ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH, but it dissociates to ammonia plus water. So overall reaction can be written KOH plus ammonium chloride to give KCl plus ammonia plus water. This is the ammonia gas. So bases react with ammonium salts to form ammonia. Easy. Property is base reacts with salts of heavier metals, salts of heavier metals to form precipitate. To form a precipitate. In first lecture, in first chapter, we have understand the precipitate. Insoluble solid mass is formed during the reaction, that is called PPT. For example, I have taken ammonium hydroxide. Again, contains OH ion, so it is a base. It reacts with salt of heavier metal. I have taken copper sulfate aqueous solution, ammonium hydroxide plus copper sulfate. What will happen? This is double displacement reaction. Ammonium sulfate is formed plus copper hydroxide. This is a precipitate formed. Actually, its color is a pale blue. It will settle down in the container. So these are the five properties of a base. We can compare with the acid also. Easy. That's it for today. Next lecture, we will discuss strength of acid and base with the pH table, with the pH concept. Stay at home, keep learning, and press the bell icon for further notifications.